Welcome to my class. In this particular session, we will talk about different types of keys in RDBMS. RDBMS refers to Relational Database Management System. So what are the different types of keys in Relational Database Management System? First of all, meaning of key. The term key, key field or key attribute means the same thing. The term key means a column or a field which contains unique values for every row or record. Let's take up a particular table. This is student table. One field is enrollment number, second is name, the third one is age, the fourth one address, and the next one is gender and course. Let us fill it up quickly. In this particular table, you will find that there is a repetition of names. The name Neha comes twice, the name Ravi comes twice. In the age 1920, it appears number of times. Similarly, the address of two students can be same. They may be sharing the same PG accommodation. So there is a possibility that the address of two students may be same. In the case of column gender, we find that there is duplication. In the case of column course, again we find BCom honors or BCom program, both courses are appearing number of times. But there is one particular field in which there is no duplication, there is no repetition, and this field contains unique values. In every row you will find that there is a different number. This unique number makes each and every row a unique one. So enrollment number is unique in every row. We can declare this enroll number as primary key. This is the main key on the basis of which we will retrieve information from the table. Few things are worth noting in the student table. The values in different fields, name, age, gender, course name, or even address may get repeated. But the enrollment number of every student has to be unique in reality. Therefore, the field enrollment number does not contain any repeated values. It is only on the basis of enrollment number the records of every student can be uniquely identified, that is, retrieved. Functions of key. Relational Database Management, RDBMS, makes use of the concept of keys to perform two important functions. A key is a column or field value in a table that is used to identify a row or record in the table. This is the first important function. The second important function is a key is a column or field value in a table that is used to establish relationship with another table. So these are the two important functions which are performed by keys. There are seven types of keys which are used in RDBMS. They are as follow. The first one primary key, second one foreign key, the third one candidate key, the fourth alternate key, the fifth one composite key, the sixth one super key, and the last one is secondary key. Let us talk about these different keys one by one. The first one is primary key. The primary key is a field. The primary key is an attribute in a table which contains unique values for every row, record or tuple. Student, you must note that row, record or tuple, it means one and the same thing, and field and attribute are one and the same thing. Enrollment number contains unique value for every record of the student. In the student table, we have seen that enrollment number contains unique values. This makes every row or record look different from others. The second is candidate key. Sometimes it may happen that a table may contain two or more fields which contain unique values, and it is possible to retrieve every record of the table with the help of any of these unique fields. Let us take up an example of vehicle table. In the vehicle table, the first field is registration number, the second one chassis number, and the third one vehicle serial number, and the fourth one is description. You can find that in the registration number column, all values are unique. Similarly, in the chassis number column, all values are unique. Even in the vehicle serial number, all serial numbers are unique. So in this particular vehicle table, we find that there are three fields, there are three columns which contain unique values. This is the registration number. Here it is written chassis number. And here we find this is vehicle serial number. All these fields are unique with every vehicle. Now, candidate key meaning. Those attributes are fields in a table which are unique in values and they are capable of becoming primary key. They are termed as candidate keys. It means any of these three fields can become primary key. So all those fields which are capable of becoming primary key, they all are termed as candidate keys. Explanation. In the vehicle table, three fields, namely registration number, chassis number, and vehicle serial number, contain unique values, and they are the potential candidate to become primary key, because with the help of any of these, any record from the vehicle table can be individually retrieved. On the basis of familiarity and greater usage, we may choose registration number as primary key. Note, every key field is a candidate key, but there cannot be more than one primary key in a table. So we declare registration number as primary key. Otherwise, all three fields are candidate keys. It means they have the capability to become primary key. But on the basis of familiarity and greater usage, we have chosen registration number as primary key. The third one is alternate key. Those fields which are potential candidate to become primary key, but they do not become, they are termed as alternate key. Example, in the vehicle table, three fields, namely registration number, chassis number, and vehicle serial number, contain unique values and they are potential candidates to become primary key. On the basis of familiarity and greater usage, if we choose the registration number as primary key, then chassis number and vehicle serial number may be called as alternate keys. It means those fields which are capable of becoming primary key, but the field which do not become primary keys, they are termed as alternate keys. Composite key. In a table, if one field or attribute solely cannot uniquely identify or retrieve a record, then we may combine two or more fields or attributes in that table, which creates a sort of uniqueness in identifying a record in the table. Therefore, a composite key is a combination of two or more attributes which uniquely identifies a record in a table. The next one is foreign key. Foreign key is a field or attribute in a table whose values correspond to the values of primary key in another table. Put it in simple words, if a particular field is a primary key in one table, but that field is also present in the second table, then in the second table we call that particular field as foreign key. In RDBMS, the concept of foreign key is used to join two different tables in such a way that allows retrieval of information from both the tables. Look at this example. We have two tables. One is student table and the second is course table. In the student table, we declare enrollment number as primary key, whereas in the course table, we declare course code as primary key. But we can see that enrollment number of student table, it is also present in course table. In the course table, we declare enrollment number as foreign key. If a particular field is a primary key in one table and that field is present in the second table also, then it is declared as foreign key in the second table. What is the purpose of this thing? When we declare the same field as foreign key, then RDBMS software joins these two tables. RDBMS combined these two tables. It means now we can retrieve some part of data from student table and some part of data from the course table. So we can have queries which may retrieve some information from student table and some information from course table. The next one is super key. A super key is a key which is a combination of two or more fields or attributes of a table whose combined value uniquely identifies a record in the table. Here we can see that we have a particular table and in which we have number of fields, enrollment number, name, age, address and mobile number. If we want to retrieve the information from this particular table, then we can declare enrollment number as primary key, which contains unique values. But here we find that there is another field, that is mobile number. It also contains unique values. If we combine these two unique values, that is enrollment number and mobile number, then we try to retrieve the information from this particular table, then these two fields shall form a super key. It means these values were already in unique form. Now it has become in a super unique form. So we call it as super key. In the table given above, if we combine the fields enrollment number and mobile number of the student to become primary key, then it results into super key. Note, any combination like enrollment number and address, name, address and mobile number, these are examples of super keys. The last one is secondary key. A secondary key is an attribute or combination of attributes which may classify an entity on the basis of particular characteristics. Example, a student may be identified on the basis of course pursued by him. However, it must be noted that this key may not bring uniqueness to a record. Therefore, it is not a candidate key. So all those fields which are not primary one, they will be termed as secondary key. Let us summarize different keys. There are seven types of keys which are used in relational database management system. First one, primary key. Second, foreign key. Third, candidate key. Fourth, alternate key. Fifth, composite key. Sixth, super key. And the last one is secondary key. These are the seven different types of keys. Thank you very much.